Hi everyone, this is Jim from the Center for Teaching, Learning, and Technology, recording a quick video today to walk you through the process of pre-assigning breakout rooms in Zoom, populating them with your students using a comma-separated value, or CSV, file. There's a lot of technical jargon going on here, but it's actually a fairly straightforward process. You just have to follow a couple rules because Zoom is a little finicky. The first thing you actually need to do is get a list of your students' email addresses. So what you do is you go to My Illinois State, log in there, and go to the Academics tab, and you will find your class schedule will populate here eventually. And you can go here to Class Roster. So this is the course I happen to be teaching this fall. And you'll see you have the option of downloading several different types of file. I'm going to select an Excel spreadsheet, and you can see it's downloaded the Excel file here. I'm not going to open that up because it has my students' confidential information in it, but you get the idea. That's how you get that list of your students' email addresses. The next thing you need to do is actually go to illinoisstate.zoom.us. That's the main ISU portal for Zoom, and even if you created the meeting that you're teaching through in ReggieNet, you have to go to this website in order to edit it and to create the breakout rooms. So I'm going to go ahead and sign in, and I'm going to go over here to meetings. And I've already created a meeting somewhere down here, test breakout rooms, all right? So I'm going to go just take a look at this for a second, and you can see here's the information. You can see that I don't have any breakout rooms set up right now, otherwise you'd see it down here. So the next thing I'm going to do is edit this meeting. And now when I scroll down, you'll be able to see there are a couple of functions that I can check off. The first thing you need to do when you're editing your meeting to add pre-assigned breakout rooms, you actually need to check this box, only authenticated users can join. By doing that, and make sure it says ISU login, by doing that, that makes sure that your students are logging in with that same email address that you're going to pre-assign them with. In other words, Zoom's not going to know who they are unless we're forcing them to sign in with their ISU credentials to begin with. Then you'll see this checkbox here, breakout room pre-assign. And you'll see you have two options. You can either create the rooms, and if you click on this, it will just allow you to manually create the rooms and type in their email addresses. But we're actually going to do the import from CSV option. So if I click on this, it gives you the option to drag and drop a CSV file here. The format of the CSV file is very important. So what you need to do is you need to actually go here and download the template. And once I download that template, I can open it up here for you and drag it over here. You'll see it's actually very simple. The first row are the headers, and these headers need to be in here, and they need to be formatted just like you see them here. Pre-assigned room name and email address. And Zoom's a little finicky, so you actually have to have them spelled exactly this way with the capital letters and everything in order for this to work. And then what you do is you put in the room you want and you put in the corresponding email address for your student. So for example, I have a generic email list which is just like what you would get when you go through My Illinois State and download your student roster. So this just has a list of email addresses for my colleagues here at CTLT. I'm just going to copy this. All right, and then I'm going to go into this spreadsheet, and I'm going to start on the second line, and I'm just going to paste in all of those email addresses. So now I can go ahead and assign them to particular rooms. If you want to have particular students with each other, you should probably go through and reorder this list of email addresses ahead of time. And then all I have to do is room one. Let's say I'm going to have four students in each group. So this is also going to be room one. And this person will also be in room one. And then I'll do room two. Okay. And so forth. So I'm going to cheat here and paste in. We'll make that one room three. Okay, and I'm just copying and pasting right now as I go along. The good news about this is you really only have to do this once, unless you're going to be changing the order of groups. All right, we'll make this group four. So I'll copy that again and paste it in. And then we'll make this group 5 or room 5. All right. So now I have each line, each row has a room name and the corresponding student. And I know that this student will be put in room 1, this student will be put in room 2, etc. So I'm going to save the file. I'm actually going to save it to my desktop. And you can save it as whatever you want. So I'm just going to call this test. And I'm going to save it to my desktop. The important thing is that I am saving this new file as a CSV file. And I'm going to save it to my desktop. Don't save it as an Excel workbook, or if you're using Numbers, if you're on a Mac, don't save it as a Numbers file. It needs to be a CSV file. So I'm going to go ahead and save that. All right, I can close out of the spreadsheet. And now, back in Zoom on the website, I can grab that file, which is over here on my other screen, and I can drag and drop it in to this area. And you'll see it has auto-populated each of these breakout rooms with the appropriate students. So now I save that. I save the meeting. And now, when I go to start this meeting, either here or through ReggieNet, that pre-assigned list will be available to me when I hit the breakout room button.